VA healthcare takes place not just in the clinic, on the ward, in the ICU, in the ED. It also takes place during the chance encounter with a patient in the hallway en route to the canteen. It takes place at a kid's soccer game when an on-call provider is summoned. And it takes place in patients' homes. VA healthcare takes place on the go.
Jen Kearns, MD, hospitalist.
So, you know, I'm a little worried about him. I mean, he's been spiking fevers all night. I'm wondering if you know whether or not he got his antibiotics this morning.
I have no idea.
You know, I think we're going to have to run back to the team room and log on the computer and check, because this is a big deal if he didn't.
That's true. Okay. That's true. Let's go.
So, I don't know. I mean, I'm pretty worried about him. He's been spiking fevers all night. I'm wondering if you know whether he got his antibiotics this morning.
You know, I have no idea.
You know, I think it's a big deal if he didn't, so we probably should just check.
Let's just check.
Okay.
Let's make sure. I agree.
All right, let's check.
He did. Yeah, he
sure
did.
Enough.
Becky Swanson, MD, hospitalist.
I love using the iPad for patient care. Healthcare is a mobile field, and being able to use everything we do on the computer at the bedside is priceless. To be able to share information with patients at the bedside, including images, their most recent tests, has made patient care much easier and is really taking it to the next level.
Healthcare providers live this on a daily basis. Perhaps that's why more than 80% of physicians in the United States already own a smartphone. Perhaps that is why there has been such demand for tablets among the physician community. 30% of U.S. physicians purchased an iPad within its first year on the market, and in a 2011 survey, 28% intended to buy one in the ensuing 6 months.
Dane Bent, MD, Assistant Chief of Anesthesia and Co-Innovator.
There are certain performance measures that we have here in the operating room. One of them is the percentage of cases that start on time in the mornings. I have a Microsoft Access database that I use to collect this information, and we have daily meetings, multidisciplinary meetings, where we have someone from anesthesia, surgery, nursing, etc. With this Apple iPad, I have mobile access to this Microsoft Access database, which means that in our meetings, the data is readily available and immediately updated.
Visual DX gives providers access to an exhaustive visual findings atlas. Let's just take a quick look at one way a provider could look up information about a skin lesion. I could say, for example, that my patient has a rash that they've developed, and that rash is a smooth papular rash that is developed on their neck, and it developed over the last few days to weeks, and the patient's in no acute distress. And simply by entering those findings, I've now taken out of this large dermatology atlas and found the 16 or 17 diagnoses that are consistent with those particular findings. And I can take a look in any of those and look at examples of what those pictures might look like of the particular lesions. So here's an example of, in fact, bed bug bites. Here's an example of an application that serves as a reference for clinicians.
Ross Fletcher, MD, Chief of Staff.
Okay, the system that you're looking at now is MVISN, and it is an innovative grant that was put together in this hospital and has been transported to the iPad. His 12-lead electrocardiogram is easily displayed here. Now, there is an ability to see this electrocardiogram compared with another, and also to measure the exact intervals between beats, and to use that interval measurement as a caliper to see whether there is a recurrence of the same event on the EKG. This is a very high-fidelity electrocardiogram, very good for making a diagnosis of an acute myocardial infarction, or for that matter, an arrhythmia such as ventricular tachycardia or rhythms disturbances of that type.
Melissa Turner, MD, primary care.
I am one of the doctors who gets paged late at night, like at 8:30 or 9 in the evening, and sometimes on a Friday night I'm out with my family and I'm being paged and I need to call these patients. And so being able to use my iPhone and get hold of the patient, look up their record in the iPhone and figure out what medications they're on, get their phone numbers, and give them a call is really helpful, as opposed to calling them not knowing anything about their background.
Ross Fletcher, MD, Chief of Staff.
You see that the electrocardiogram comes through quite well on the iPhone itself. These complexes can be enlarged, but to read this in a very high fidelity manner is quite easy. And it's the same iPhone that I can see the patient viewer and all the patient's records of the information that you just saw. Having these systems available and quick to use is extremely valuable. Wherever I am, I can see real-time data. I've been around long enough to know that when people describe an electrocardiogram over the phone and I try to make the diagnosis, there is a problem. And I frequently come in later that day or later the next morning and can make an easy diagnosis having just seen the morphology for a few seconds.
Dane Bent, Assistant Chief of Anesthesia and Co-Innovator.
The extra advantage now is that we can use these Apple iPhones to access patient information on the go.
Let's take a look at the Patient Viewer app. So here we find ourselves in the newly developed Patient Viewer app. Why don't we look up a patient? Somebody named Smith. This is a demo patient, doesn't really exist. And here we have our demo patient, Mr. Smith. And this information, their demographics, problem list, allergies, inpatient medication, outpatient medications, and non-VA medications are brought in real-time directly out of VistA. We can move to the next tab and see more information on prescriptions, including specifics about their refills, when it was ordered, when it expires, and information pulled directly from CPRS for each of the medications. We can view laboratory results, including graphing those laboratory results over time. If we switch over to the calendar function, we see here my week schedule. And for the first time ever, I'm able to display my clinic schedule completely integrated with my Outlook schedule. You see my clinic patients that I saw, for example, this morning, listed in blue, and the fact that I'm producing a video this afternoon in purple.
Neil Evans, MD, Associate Chief of Staff, Informatics Co-Chief, Primary Care.
Mobile health. It's about the care of the patient. Healthcare happens when you're on the move. Health happens when you're on the move, whether you're the patient, the caregiver, or the giver of care, the provider. The mobile platform is the way of the future, and we need to deliver the ability to care for patients right here in the hands of both our patients and our staff.
Credits. Innovation Team. Ross Fletcher, MD, Chief of Staff. Neil Evans, MD, Co-Innovator, Associate Chief of Staff, Informatics, Co-Chief, Primary Care. Dane Bent, MD, Co-Innovator and Assistant Chief of Anesthesia. Jen Kearns, MD, Hospitalist. Becky Swenson, MD, Hospitalist. Special thanks to Vic Fontanet, Jr., VA Patient, Video Production, VHA, OHI, Innovation.